clicked to know what the 5G internet connection and network is all about in Africa, West Africa, particularly for Ghana and Nigeria, I would advise you watch this video till the end because we are about to introduce the new giant of Africa. You heard that, right? No, without mixing words. Watch this video till the end and you will be glad you did. So without any further ado, come, let's delve into this video. Thank you so much for tuning in to watch today's episode. Just like you've seen according to the title, tell me, what is a fast rising, a fast developing country without quality internet technology, aka 5G network? Okay, I know we're going to say that countries in Africa are way behind, at least way behind what we have going on out there in the Western European countries compared to their 5G network that has way and long begun years back. And currently, because of innovation, invention, this is when most African countries are thinking it twice, are thinking it wise, and very evolutionary and rational in terms of their what? Internet technology improvement. And of a truth, I will say that the major reason why I think currently, in the course of this video, as you're definitely going to find out, why in Africa, amidst the fact that we know that the most common and all-known internet network provider, which is MTN from South Africa, that has spread around most countries in Africa and West Africa, have really done well in terms of their network and internet connection and what have you. MTN in a nutshell has really done more good coming all the way from South Africa to Nigeria down to Ghana. And I think so far so good, some countries, particularly the country Ghana, the motherland Ghana, has seen reasons why MTN might not really or should not really be a thing or a major network provider or internet provider for them. Because we all know that no matter how we try to pretend, no matter how we shy away from the bitter truth, getting quality internet in Africa, particularly my dear country Nigeria and some other countries like Ghana, it's actually a hassle. And the idea and innovation of coming up with inventions and technology in partnership with all the countries to facilitate, to mitigate and improve in internet connection in West Africa, for Ghana and Nigeria, is actually a thing. And it's high time we begin to have this as a major conversation, because there are definitely almost nothing we can say we are doing with internet that does not require data and the use of internet, especially the 5G innovation. And with the cause of this, I had to look deep in countries in Africa that has really gone far with the 5G connection, or where the 5G internet connection has been spread out to. And I could find out that at the end of the day, it's just limited about 5 or 6 or approximately 10 countries in Africa, West Africa, that has this 5G connection, and it's actually a thing. Now, categorically, bit by bit, we are going to look at what the 5G internet technology is all about in Nigeria, how it started, if it has started, how it is going on there, and if actually it is thriving. We will now liken it to what we have coming from South Africa, which is the host country, right, for internet and technology, in quotes, MTN. Then at the end of the day, look at critically what Ghana, like I said, has going on there, that is definitely, without mixing words, making them, topping them the list right among the fast rising countries in terms of internet and technology. And when I tell you that Ghana is thinking and acting fast in terms of evolution and beating world record, I am not kidding you. And in the course of this video, of a truth, let's just leave it at that for now and take a look at what it's going on there, if the 5G network in Nigeria is actually worth it or it actually is scam.
It's been 4 months since the Nigerian Communications Commission confirmed issuance of the final letters of award of the fifth generation spectrum licenses to interested telecom service operators. And now, the technology, already live in most countries abroad, is up and running in Nigeria. However, one of the vendors, MTN, responsible for the rollout, is yet to fully implement 100% 4G coverage, and its CEO has only expressed optimism to reach 80% by the end of 2022 as the company switches its attention to 5G. Although the NCC did not say what the criteria for selecting those to handle the rollout of the latest network generation is, experts believe a vista of opportunities has been opened.
One of the benefits of 5G technology is that it has 100 times the capacity of 4G technology, theoretically. But basically, it holds the promise of being able to deliver high-quality broadband to more Nigerians than ever before.
The 5G has several frequencies that it can work on, from as low as 6 gigahertz to as high as 60 gigahertz. So any operator can work in any of these frequencies, and that gives them the opportunity to leverage the pipeline to now deliver services, then the speed is a lot faster.
Industry analysts have also been clearing the air on the equipment to be used.
Most of the airports that will be close to 5G deployment have not been recalibrated for 5G towers or 5G radio emissions. So there might be some interference with already existing aviation transmission technologies.
When the G's change, nothing changes about, you're still dealing with the same type of antenna. Now, what you may see is that there may be more antennas on the towers, and you may see them in more places. But that's because the level of service required to deliver simple voice versus high-speed video is very, very different. So the networks will get denser.
The health effects of the 5G technology on humans has always been a cause for concern for many, but those fears have been allayed by medical experts, including the WHO, which concluded that after much research performed, no adverse health effect has been causally linked with exposure to wireless technologies. Health-related conclusions are drawn from studies performed across the entire radio spectrum, and provided that the overall exposure remains below international guidelines, no consequences for public health are anticipated.
In fact, Aru, Ademola, and Nwankwo, three of the Nigerian researchers, they went to investigate this to see how much damage this would do to the human DNA. And they found that there's no substantial evidence to dictate or to say that there will be any harmful effect or any change to the human DNA.
Data from the Nigerian Communications Commission show that Nigeria's broadband penetration increased from 40.9% in February 2022 to 44.5% in July 2022. Now, this is a significant rise from what was obtainable 5 years ago, as penetration has grown from 19.78% in July 2017 to 44.5% in July 2022. But will this rollout aid Nigeria's target of 70% broadband penetration by 2025?
I would say no. We need to now ask ourselves a question. How does this now begin to affect the lives of the ordinary Nigerians? Because as it is now, the ordinary Nigerian can't even afford the devices to connect to the 5G network. I hope that we'll see that in a very short period of time. And I hope that it will be a collaborative effort, not the usual business model of competing against each other that we've been used to.
The NCC has listed limited frequencies with the required spectral efficiency, skilled professionals with requisite knowledge of the technology, fewer 5G-enabled devices, and cost of deployment, amongst others, as challenges that might be faced during the rollout phase. So far, the rollout has only taken effect in 190 sites spread across Abuja and Lagos, with the hope of spreading to other cities in the future when other telecommunications entities acquire the requisite equipment and license to roll out. Victor Mathias, Channels Television News.
A new logo that got mixed reactions to a new direction for the company, and last but most certainly not the least, 5G coming soon in Nigeria. But what exactly is MTN up to, and what are we to expect from them? Well, the brand is looking to be digital first in its service offerings, and that is what is informing its ambition 2025 strategy. Basically, the plan is to build leading digital platforms that enable Africa's progress across the telecom, fintech, infrastructure, API, and content messaging ecosystem by 2025. And one of the first steps towards that change will be to look the part. This is sort of MTN's declaration that they are a brand who are in touch with the times and proactive enough to position themselves for the future. They're saying, hey, we're a brand that understands what young Africans need. And from my point of view, I do think it's a wise move to expand into exploring the limitless possibilities that tech has to offer and satisfying the expanding scope of, you know, their customers' digital needs. I mean, beyond just servicing the mobile phone, although that has obviously, you know, that's something that's obviously worked out well for MTN so far. You can just look at the numbers. The tech space in Nigeria specifically and Africa as a whole has exploded in the past few years. The continent has produced several unicorn startups in the past 2 decades alone, and all of them have solved major problems involving financial inclusion for Africans, e-commerce, and, you know, connecting African talent to a global client. Some analysts have already predicted that this explosive growth will be replicated or even doubled over the next decade. I think that MTN is trying to get in on this early enough, hence why they are switching to a more tech and fintech focused approach to the services they will be offering very soon. However, one thing that is important to point out is that while MTN is looking to serve a largely digital younger generation, it also promises to, you know, be there still for the older, less digitally informed adults in the space. Before we move on, it is important to point out that the rebrand that MTN has done and all the new products and services that are to come with it may still be a few months down the line. So it may take some patience for us to start getting the results for all of this work. While there is now a world of possibilities for what MTN can achieve with this rebrand, we do know that we're definitely going to be seeing more digital offerings from the brand. Also, whatever the brand does bring to the space will certainly be a boost. So at the moment, the company company is still working to finally get the full license to have everything kick off fully and properly. All right, let's now talk about the one thing that most people are interested in, 5G. MTN, when is 5G coming? With every person that asked the question of 5G, MTN had the same answer.
Coming soon.
While everyone is eager to start loading pages at the snap of their fingers and just download 1 gigabyte in 1 second, MTN is still yet to give a date for when they'll be rolling out 5G capabilities for their SIM cards. For now, all we'll have to hang on to is soon. While soon is usually a tactic that most brands use to avoid giving a definite answer for something that they're still unsure of, there might be reason to believe that soon might actually be soon. I was privileged to speak with some of the people at the NCC, and here's what I can say for now. Right now, there is something unique about the fifth generation of mobile network, 5G. 5G infrastructure is designed to work in two formats. The first form is the standalone network infrastructure, or SA, and the non-standalone network infrastructure, or NSA. Not the same NSA that you know. These two names will feel pretty self-explanatory once you understand them, and they could be the key to getting 5G up and running in Nigeria sooner rather.
Okay guys, having heard from the news and what Fisayo, one of our very best tech internet guru, has already told us, let's take a look at what the 5G network currently is today, in what shape and form it is making wave in the country Nigeria, and we'll be right back to analyze more on it.
This is MTN's 5G modem, and I've had it for over 20 days. I've tested it and I've used it to download a 2 gigabyte game in less than 2 minutes. I've gotten speeds over 1000 Mbps, and I've been streaming 4K seamlessly and gaming faster than I've ever done in Nigeria, at least. There's been a lot of discussion about the MTN 5G router, but what is it like to live with this for almost a month? In this video, I'll be sharing my full thoughts on this router and if it's worth spending your hard-earned 50,000 naira to pre-order it. It's inside this box, and how do I set it up? Inside the box, the first thing we get is the modem, of course. I've got this in white, but you can get it in two other colors, which are yellow and black. The rear part of the router has a lot of ports and buttons. From the top, we've got this WPS button where you press and hold to activate WPS. You have two TS9 external antenna ports with a range of up to 4200 megahertz. You've got a telephone port, two LAN ports in case you want to connect it to a PC, and you're actually supplied with a LAN cable out of the box. And lastly, the power port. Underneath the modem is where we have the slots where your nano SIM card goes into. You need a valid nano SIM card to be inserted. Underneath the modem, you also have to register at MTN's office. The reset hole is where you simply put a needle or pin in there and you reset your modem to factory settings, and a USB-C port which doesn't work for data storage. The text there also labels it as an input for 12 volt or 1.5 amp. We plug the power bank in here and it didn't charge. We also plugged it into a computer. It didn't show up as storage, so we kind of think it's for firmware updates. Then to the right side of it is where we've got the other details like the router name and password. The front of the modem is where we get three signal bars. Of course, it's low, medium, and high. And if this network signal is red, it means that the SIM isn't inside, or it's not registered on the network, or there's just no network at all. It turns blue if it's on a 4G network and white if it's 5G. When the Wi-Fi light is on, it's turned on. When it's blinking, it's WPS. And when it's off, of course, Wi-Fi is off. And the last light below is the power indicator, which shows when the modem is turned on or when it's turned off. Basically, if everything is all white, you're good to go. We also get the power adapter for the modem, the manual, and the nano SIM pack, which we already took the SIM from and is inside the modem. The modem doesn't have an inbuilt battery, so you have to rely on a stable power supply. One thing MTN did with the Highness Flex was provide this power bank, and I tested it with my 5G modem. It lasted up to 9 hours and 30 minutes, and I think that was a brilliant move by MTN. The power bank actually connects to the normal power from this point and then to the modem from this other point here, so it acts like an inverter, and then it lasts long when there's no power. I do hope that they consider it for this 5G router, but that might make the cost a bit higher maybe. Anyway, this is how the router looks all around. It's got MTN branding on it with 5G, and it's also got what looks like vents on it. I did check, and it's a ZTE router which debuted in South Africa, of course, with MTN. And that's everything we get in the box. Now let's move straight into the tests. I'll limit this to speed tests, millisecond tests, or ping for gaming, and then downloading a file. For my 5G test, I actually tested it in three different locations in Lagos. I tested it in Ikoyi, and that was where I was getting around 800 to 1000 Mbps. In Victoria Island, you know, Shoprite Palms, I was getting 500 to 700 Mbps, and in Lekki Phase 1, I was reaching 700 to 850 Mbps. This is in comparison to 4G speeds, which wouldn't hit these numbers on a good day. 4G barely hits 100 Mbps, so this is really 10 times faster. These speeds don't apply to everyone everywhere all the time, of course, and it won't be the same in all the locations, but the speeds were interesting to see. Of course, another thing is that at night, your speed will be much, much faster, and all my tests were done during the day, so there you have it. I tested this 5G router in a location without 5G, and I got much better speeds than I would normally get on a 4G connection. In general, I noticed that my 4G speeds got faster, and for some reason, many people believe that MTN reduced the 4G speed because they wanted to launch 5G, and you just hear from the CMO.
No, the 5G network rollout does not directly and negatively impact the 4G network.
Okay, guys, now of a truth, I can say that from what we have based on the news few years back and currently still in 2024, almost 2025, Nigeria is still on the 5G network based on MTN and some other network providers internet in terms of their 5G. It's actually a thing that I think for Nigeria should be way above where they are today. At the end of the day, getting the router or getting a sophisticated phone that is 5G infused and the router that is 5G infused is not really accessible or will not really spread out to most citizens in the country and most areas, locations in the country. So where the government is lagging behind is not trying to see how they can invent in terms of partnering with other countries that will provide this network, own it for themselves, just like they will definitely look at from the motherland Ghana. So with that being said, I will say that in this present day and time, it is actually a hassle and it is actually a struggle for most internet users in Nigeria, for them finding it very difficult to connect in terms of internet. And me seated here, myself, I can tell you of a truth that it is actually a struggle even with the 4G network and even with the 4G router. Most times in the locations I find myself, it's actually a thing, it's actually a hassle of a truth. And I would say the government of Nigeria should definitely please look out for ways that they can, you know, improve in their internet technology or facet whatsoever. I actually took a glimpse into the South Africa 5G network to see what they have going on there, being the major network country provider for most West African and African countries. And I came out to realize that they are also on the same 5G router and phone internet provisions that they are currently using. Just what we can see here right now.
Finally, 5G is here and it is in this box. Not the actual 5G, like the 5G enabled device that will enable me to be a 5G. See what I did there? Never mind. This is when you know something is going to be good. When your box has shock absorbers. The LG velvet. It's smooth like velvet. So ladies and gents, what you're seeing here is a 5G device. This basically means no more buffering, no more awkward Zoom calls. You know the Zoom calls where someone's talking and then they freeze. And then when they turn back, their mustache is still stuck in the first frame. None of that. No. Okay, let's put the speed to the test. Up. Look at that. We're climbing. Look at all the way to 800, just like that. This is how fast 5G is. Let's see how quick 5G will allow me to download my favorite show. I'm going to see how much of Ngosi Sikelel I can get through before this app is done. Ngosi Sikelel. Oh, that's a 36-minute app done. Ladies and gentlemen, 5G. It's here, inside this phone. 5G. Faster than fast. Faster than black people sing through the Gegebech, this part of the anthem. I don't know how to do it. Never mind. From myself and my shell, I've been in Pop Pops, and you have been nothing short of amazing.
Now, looking at this coming from South Africa, I can say of a truth, it is something that is definitely way below what they are supposed to be operating on, okay? There should be definitely room for improvements, innovations, inventions, and what have you. And judging from what we have seen for South Africa and Nigeria, what the 5G network and internet provision, innovation, invention, and currently running for this country is all about, ladies and gentlemen, this is where the game changer actually is for the motherland Ghana. We'll take a close look at it critically, analytically, without sentiment and bias, and tell me at the end of this video if this is not worth it or this is not innovation and evolution coming in there in the motherland Ghana. Quickly look at this and we'll be right back.
In April this year, a bit of crash happened between MTN Ghana and the government of Ghana. What brought about this friction was that MTN Ghana was running a very affordable internet data offer to its customers, which they named the MTN Zoom Bundle. But the government told MTN to stop offering its customers this affordable internet data. The reason of the government was that MTN is the leading holder of the market share of mobile subscription in Ghana. In fact, according to Statista.com, MTN Ghana alone has about 63% of the market share of mobile subscription in Ghana. So the government did that to control the monopoly of MTN in the country. Well, MTN customers who were benefiting from this Zoom bundle were very, very angry at the government. But apart from the monopoly of MTN the government was trying to break, they were also planting something bigger for Ghanaians within the Ghana internet space. And this Ghanaian minister, who is responsible for communication, is here to break that news.
The Ministry of Communications and Digitalization also recognizes the importance of equitable access to voice and data communications in today's interconnected world. Now, I'm happy to announce, and you're the first to hear this, that building on this rural telephony project model. Approval has just been granted for the establishment of a neutral shared infrastructure company delivering nationwide 4G and exclusive 5G services in Ghana by a consortium of existing network operators and private investors. I'm excited at the opportunity this will provide for scaling up access to affordable high-speed broadband internet services nationwide. I'm told that high-speed broadband connectivity is only available to about 10% of internet users in this country. With this, we're hoping to treble the access, high-speed broadband access across the country.
That is not all. They are also going to extend their fiber optics infrastructure to other West African countries.
Our commitment to technological advancement goes beyond our borders, as we believe in growing with the rest of the continent. And so we're building our fiber networks to our borders to enable easy connectivity to our neighboring.
Wait, before Honorable continues, we would like to share with you a brief history of the internet in Ghana and the future of it. But before that, please don't forget to like this video and also subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Now, let's dive into it. The internet was first introduced to Ghana in the early 1990s. In 1993, Network Computer Systems registered the country's first domain name, gh.com. In 1995, Ghana became the second African country to have a full internet connectivity after South Africa. The early years of internet in Ghana were very slow. This is because the country's infrastructure was not yet developed enough to support the widespread of internet access. However, the situation began to improve in the early 2000s because the government invested in telecommunication infrastructure and the private sector also began to offer internet services. Today, internet access in Ghana is relatively widespread. According to a report, there are about 6.6 million social media users in Ghana as of January 2023. This 6.6 million people represent 19.5% of the country's total population, which is 30 million. And again, there were about 23 million internet users in Ghana at the start of 2023, with the country's internet penetration standing at 63.2%. But at the time this video was being recorded, internet penetration in Ghana has increased to 71.94%. This number is still expected to grow in the coming years. So the government continues to invest in infrastructure so that the private sector will also be able to offer affordable internet services to Ghanaians. Currently, the country's internet comes from 5 submarine operators, 3 mobile network operators, and 4 fiber operators. But now they want to do more. And what they are doing this time around is that they are now spreading affordable internet nationwide. How are they doing this? Well, according to the Ghanaian Minister responsible for communication and digitalization, Honorable Esla Owusu Ekufo, approval has been given to consortium to build and maintain a nationwide fiber optic network that will be shared by all telecommunication operators in the country to set up a 4G and 5G network so that all operators can use it and extend it to about 80% of the Ghanaian population. They are also going to extend this fiber optics infrastructure to other West African countries. This will help service providers to extend their services to rural areas with affordable internet to Ghanaians and other West African countries. Let's hear this and more from Honorable Esla Owusu Ekufo.
The Ministry of Communications and Digitalization also recognizes the importance of equitable access to voice and data communications in today's interconnected world. And to narrow the rural-urban digital divide, we are undertaking the Ghana Rural Telephony and Digital Inclusion Project, which is a strategic initiative to provide connectivity to rural and remote areas of Ghana. It involves the government bearing the cost of deploying a network of 2016 telecommunications infrastructure such as cell towers, base stations, and fiber optic cables to extend the network to approximately 4 million previously underserved and unserved communities and citizens in Ghana. So far, 1,010 sites have been deployed, and the remaining 1,006 will be completed by the end of this year. In the finest example of public-private partnerships, the government is providing the infrastructure, while all network operators utilize this infrastructure to provide services to their subscribers as a shared infrastructure. We're implementing national roaming on this network too. So regardless of your service provider, your device will pick up the strongest signal on the network, wherever you are within its catchment area. This is a deliberate government policy to promote active and passive infrastructure sharing, national roaming, and tower co-location to reduce capital expenditure in the telecom sector, particularly in our rural areas, delivering competitively priced services to subscribers who otherwise would have remained unconnected. By facilitating connectivity to rural areas, we're enabling the local populations to access essential services, including health, education, agricultural guidance, e-government services, and improved communication capabilities are also fostering economic development by facilitating e-commerce, digital entrepreneurship, and access to market information. Now, I'm happy to announce, and you're the first to hear this, that building on this rural telephony project model, approval has just been granted for the establishment of a neutral shared infrastructure company delivering nationwide 4G and exclusive 5G services in Ghana by a consortium of existing network operators and private investors. I'm excited at the opportunity this will provide for scaling up access to affordable high-speed broadband internet services nationwide for all network operators, ISPs, mobile virtual network operators as well, to either set up shop or expand their operations. I'm told that high-speed broadband connectivity is only available to about 10% of internet users in this country. With this, we're hoping to treble the access, high-speed broadband access across the country. Our commitment to technological advancement goes beyond our borders.
So Ghana has been making some serious waves in the tech world lately. In fact, the country is now about to make some serious internet upgrades. We are talking about a nationwide affordable 5G network for everyone. And that is going to be a game changer for the beautiful country and the entire African continent.
Now I'm happy to announce, and you're the first to hear this, that building on this rural telephony project model, approval has just been granted for the establishment of a neutral shared infrastructure company delivering nationwide 4G and exclusive 5G services in Ghana by a consortium of existing network operators and private investors. I'm excited at the opportunity this will provide for scaling up access to affordable high-speed broadband internet services nationwide. I'm told that high-speed broadband connectivity is only available to about 10% of internet users in this country. With this, we're hoping to treble the access, high-speed broadband access across the country.
Ghana is set to become one of the first African countries to offer a widespread 5G network. But there is a twist. They are taking a unique approach with a company called Next Gen Infrastructure Company, NGIC for short. So let's think of NGIC as a digital highway. This company will build and manage the infrastructure, making it accessible to all mobile network operators in Ghana. This shared network approach aims to keep costs down, making 5G affordable for everyone in the country. This initiative is a collaboration between the government of Ghana, Radisys Corporation, which is a subsidiary of Reliance Industries, owned by Asia's richest man, Mukesh Ambani, and a tech giant like Nokia and Microsoft. In fact, it is a big investment. NGIC plans to pour over $145 million into Ghana's infrastructure over the next 3 years. Ghana's Minister of Communication, Honorable Esla Osu Ekufo, sees this as a game changer.
With this, we're hoping to treble the access, high-speed broadband access across the country.
Affordable 5G will boost internet connectivity across the country and some nearby countries as well.
Our commitment to technological advancement goes beyond our borders, as we believe in growing with the rest of the continent. And so we're building our fiber networks to our borders to enable easy connectivity to our neighboring countries.
It is a key step in achieving their digital vision. Ghana is inspired by Indian success with low-cost mobile data and want to replicate that in Ghana. This Indian's low-cost data system was built by Ambani's Jio, which shook up the market with low-cost data plans and free voice call. Jio's strategy is credited with making mobile internet accessible to hundreds of millions of Indians today. And that is exactly what Ghana is going to do. Here's the thing. NGIC won't directly sell you data plans. In fact, they will provide a backbone for existing mobile operators like MTN Ghana, Telcel Ghana, and AT Ghana to offer the 5G services to their customers. This will foster competition, which will help keep prices even even lower. With a rapid growing internet user in Ghana, which is over 70%, the country is primed for this technological leap. Affordable 5G networks promises faster downloads, smoother streaming, and a whole new level of mobile connectivity. This is a big step toward a more digital future for Ghana and Africa. Imagine students downloading textbooks in an instant, businesses collaborating seamlessly online, and folks in remote areas finally getting connected. The possibilities are endless. So, what are you waiting for? Let's get Ghana connected with this kind of innovation. The future of Ghana and Africa is looking brighter. So stay tuned, because we will be back to explore how this 5G revolution is unfolding.
Now, this was actually years back. Let's look at the current update in 2024 and see what again is happening, if it was just mere talk or they are actually following up and working towards it immensely.
So this video is an update on our video about Ghana's internet upgrades, where Ghana is set to become one of the first African nations to offer a nationwide 5G network through a collaboration between the government of Ghana, Radisys Corporation, a subsidiary of Reliance Industries led by Mukesh Ambani, Asia's richest man, and tech giants like Nokia and Microsoft. Today, Ghana's Communication Minister, Honorable Esla Osu Ekufo, addressed the media where she revealed details about this amazing collaboration. Let's hear everything from here.
Ghana is well positioned for 5G implementation due to a robust regulatory framework, existing infrastructure, market demand, and government support. Our proactive approach and commitment to innovation has positioned us as a leader in digital transformation in Africa. Countries like Malaysia, Germany, and the United States have shown success with similar shared infrastructure models. Malaysia's Digital National Berhad, DNB, has expanded 5G coverage, aiming to cover 50% of rural areas by mid-2024. Germany promotes infrastructure sharing for efficient resource use. The US encourages innovation and reduces costs through initiatives like open radio access networks, Open RAN. The shared network infrastructure model aims to reduce investment pressures on incumbent MNOs while delivering best-in-class 5G services to all consumers. By increasing speeds and network capacity, 5G will open up opportunities for greater bandwidth, enabling significant data transmission compared to 4G LTE. This will drive economic growth, foster innovation, create new jobs, and open new business opportunities in various sectors. This initiative is a significant step towards achieving a fully digitalized Ghana by 2030. I'd like to acknowledge our key partners here. Nokia is providing, and it's a Finnish company. It's a company based in Finland. It is providing a state-of-the-art radio access network and has committed to set up its first technology innovation lab in Accra, offering career opportunities for engineering graduates in the technology sector and creating 5G use cases for the continent. Another partner, Tech Mahindra, a global managed services company and the prime contractor for the cloud-native core network from Microsoft, will build a cloud-native core network powered by leading equipment OEM platforms to support the deployment of network infrastructure and associated services. This cutting-edge technology will ensure that our network is robust, scalable, and capable of supporting future innovations. Tech Mahindra will also set up its first global software delivery center in Ghana, enabling our youth to acquire cutting-edge skills and lead in AI, robotics, machine learning, and automation. Radisys, a geo-platform company, is providing open radio access network, Open RAN, to enable disaggregated networks for 4G and 5G mobile and fixed wireless access. Radisys also brings affordable 4G and 5G devices along with digital platforms and applications, fostering sustainable and inclusive development. This collaboration with NGIC is its first venture in Africa and hopefully will be the first of many. Its partner company, Reliance Jio, set up barely 8 years ago, is currently the largest mobile network operator in the world with 477 million subscribers. We hope a little bit of their magic will rub off on us in Ghana and through NGIC, the rest of Africa. A lot of interest is being shown in NGIC in the global world of technology, as this model is the first of its kind in Africa. We hope it will be replicated in other parts of the continent, showcasing that it is possible, with Ghana leading the way as the digital black star of Africa. In conclusion, the Akufo-Addo Bahumia government is committed to ensuring equal access to internet connectivity throughout the country. This shared network infrastructure for 5G represents a strategic move to provide affordable, high-speed mobile broadband services, reduce the digital divide, and promote financial inclusion. This initiative is a significant step towards achieving a fully digitized Ghana by 2030. We look forward to the successful deployment of nationwide 4G, 5G services and the transformative impact it will have on the lives of Ghanaians. Ghana, 100% digital. It is possible indeed.
During her engagement, the Honorable Minister was asked whether this new upgrade will increase mobile data prices in the country or it's going to help reduce it.
This is good news to every Ghanaian. But there's a saying that every quality thing comes with high costs. I want to find out whether the deployment of this 5G service will increase the cost of data, because we are already suffering, whether it will cost high data pages for Ghanaians.
And this is what she said.
We don't expect there to be any corresponding increase in the cost of data merely because of the introduction of 5G. A different service is being provided. If you want to sign on to it, you subscribe to it. If you want to enjoy your existing service, you do it at the rate set by your network operator. I expect that because this is a shared infrastructure which reduces the cost for the network operators, they will transfer that into better service offerings, and it may even lead to a lowering of the cost of delivering that service, which can only inure to the benefit of subscribers. Now, if individual MNOs had to build this network themselves, this is a very capital intensive industry and it is very expensive to roll out mobile networks infrastructure. And that is why government took a strategic decision to use a shared infrastructure network company to deliver the service.
All right, guys, you can see and say of a truth that it is not a joke. It is actually a dream come true. It is actually a reality, or has become a reality, for the motherland Ghana. Do you know what it means, having watched what the government of Ghana is actually putting up for the country in this 24th century? And I bet you, like you've rightly heard, by the time this whole thing will be finally done and set, even we Nigerians and other countries in West Africa will follow suit, because that is the goal and that should be the aim for countries who wants to do well, who wants to improve for themselves. Looking at what they have going on, that is definitely going to be self-owned, country-owned for they themselves, which is the first, I kid you not, in Africa. Like, the first in Africa is actually mind-blowing. Now tell me again, what is a fast rising country, a fast developing country, a country that is thinking fast and acting fast compared to the Western European country in this present day and time? Haven't seen what we have going on for the motherland other than this, and more, and even more. And this is not just to demote any of these countries in West Africa, in Africa, because the aim is definitely to see what other countries in West Africa, in Africa, has going on, the steps they are taking, the moves they are taking in all facets of growth, technology, improvement, and what have you that a country is required of, and follow suit, nothing more, nothing less. And that's why I find it very, very interesting to come out here and to enlighten, educate, entertain, motivate, inspire us as countries, as citizens in West Africa and Africa to the world. And ladies and gentlemen, at this point, I want to say the country Ghana is doing well for themselves, as well the country Nigeria. If definitely our leaders will key in, sit up, follow up things squarely the way it's supposed to be, Nigeria teaming up with Ghana and some other countries in West Africa would definitely stand out in Africa, making Africa a continent in the globe and in the map. And now I can tell you that the new giant of Africa that we are actually witnessing and experiencing before our eyes is no other country than the motherland Ghana. That definitely, at the end of the day, if time is not taken, with the speed, length and capacity that the country Ghana is moving with, oh my God, in all facets, we'll be nowhere compared to the Western European countries. I kid you not, without mixing words. And that is it, guys. At this point, I need you definitely, sincerely, without sentiment and bias, to to leave your earnest, candid opinion right there in the comment section. As a citizen of any country, right? What do you think about what's going on in these countries? What they have going on in terms of their internet technology based off their 5G network in their phones, in their gadgets, in their router, and what have you? What do you actually think? What are your thoughts and your opinion? Kindly leave them all in the comment section. And yes, with this, I will say we've come to the end of this episode. And if this is your first time seeing this face, hi, this is Chivik Inspirations. And here in Chivik Inspirations, we say things just the way it is, not to demean, spite, demote, demarket any citizen, any country in West Africa, in Africa, but to promote, expose, analyze, react to things that are happening, innovations, inventions, facilities, growth and development that we have going on for countries in West Africa, particularly my dear country Nigeria and the motherland Ghana and some other countries in West Africa and even citizens, right? And this is to say that I actually have a kind of resentment for South Africa, right, as a country, because of a truth, from my observation all this while as an adult growing up as an individual, I can say of a truth, South Africa has not been fair in terms of their actions, their character, and most things that they have going on for themselves concerning Nigeria and some other countries in West Africa and in Africa. I don't know what it is for them, of a truth, in terms of their character, the way they behave, the way they react to most countries. And I don't even want to go into all that because it's not why we're here for today. But what I would say, if you are a South African watching right now, without sentiment and bias, I will say no country is perfect, no country is the best. We are countries in West Africa that are thriving. Despite our struggles, our challenges, the world economy and its difficulties globally, we are not perfect, even as citizens. Nigeria has their flaws as citizens and as countries. The same thing goes with Ghana and other countries. But for you South Africans to always have it as a thing to always, most times, be ahead along with other countries, particularly Nigeria, it's never a thing to encourage. And I can say of a truth, when you want to look at vice versa what Ghana has in terms of their characteristics, their behavior that is personal, that is individual to them, you can say there is great difference. Okay, you can never, I repeat, find the country and the good people of Ghana in such spotlight that is negative and detrimental to them. They always carry themselves with so much integrity, respect and humility wherever they find themselves, and that's another unique trait that makes them stand out and think fast, that helps them do better. Looking at where Nigeria is fighting and, you know, concentrating on things that are not helping them, they are lagging behind and other people are passing them by. And looking at South Africa feeling on top of the world, doing as though they are the real thing, or they are the only one in Africa, is actually a discredit to them. If looking at what they have, businesses that is cut across most countries in Africa, that other countries are really supportive of them, patronizing them, partnering with them, is actually what we as countries in West Africa want to look at, their character and the way they react and behave to countries in West Africa, despite what it is. Despite what it is, I don't think most companies they have in Nigeria, in some other West African countries, will thrive and do better, or will even survive. So let's look at things from the wider angle, from a more broader, peaceful and rational angle, right? So that in all, at the end of the day, we as countries in Africa, beginning with you South Africans, will know that this world is way beyond what we think and is unpredictable, right? Now look at what Ghana has going. Now look at what Ghana has going on. Whoever will predict or come to a realization that Ghana will be where they are today, and they are not even there yet. And the same thing with Nigeria. Please, let's shun hate, let's shun bitterness, acrimony, animosity for each other as countries in Africa, in West Africa, because united as Africans we stand, and divided we will fall. And you know that with unity, peace and love, we will conquer the world and conquer the globe at the end of the day, which is the goal and should be our dream, our ambition and our target. Thank you so much for this few minutes that I have really ministered to us as citizens and countries in Africa, West Africa. If you can actually relate to what I have just said, kindly leave your thoughts also in the comment section. And with this, I will say we've come to the end of this episode. If you did enjoy today's episode, hit the like button, share this video so that more people will get enlightened, inspired, motivated, educated, and as well entertained as a result of you sharing this video. And if you're yet to join this family, haven't heard and seen what you have experienced today here on this channel, why not hit on that button that says subscribe, which is totally and absolutely free of charge, right? And I'll be very grateful and glad you did. Thank you so, so much once again for patiently listening and watching till this moment. God bless you richly. And remember, you owe yourself nothing but your peace of mind, your happiness, and your sanity. Till I come up here again in my next one, but for now, this is me, Chivik Inspirations, saying do have a peaceful, a lovely, a successful day out there. Till I see you in my next one. Bye, guys.